Alrighty, so we are live and it's Tuesday live session. It's our very first live session in the year 2022. All right, while we're here live and streaming, we are going to be trying to connect to our Facebook community. Please, if you're here, do let me know that you're here. Send a chat and tell me that you are here. My name is Wendy Ologe and I'm the founder of the Intentional Parent Academy. Yes, Ella, I see you. I will try to connect to our Facebook community. Please, if you're here, do let me know that you are here. Okay. All right. Tell me where you are streaming live from also. If you tell me where you are streaming live from, it would also make it a lot more easier. Where are you streaming live from? All right. Yes, I can see quite a number of parents in the inner circle. I see you, Yadas. I see you guys. All right. So let's connect to the community on Facebook and then we would roll. Just tell us where you are streaming live from and we would be on in the next few minutes. Okay. So this is our Tuesday live. Who is as excited as I am to be back on the Tuesday live? Alrighty, so we should be live right now on all the communities, all right? Yes, Facebook community, we're here. Thank you. We are live and is our Tuesday live session. And my name is Wendy Ologe and I'm the founder of the Intentional Parent Academy, right? The Intentional Parent Academy is here to teach you how to parent your children, all right? I know that many people, when they hear that, they are wondering, what is she talking about? Yes. All right. So, hey, Yadas, I see you guys. Joy, I see you. All right, if you are watching me on the Facebook community, I know that you're just connecting. Please do let me know where you are streaming live from. I'm streaming live from the capital city of Nigeria, Abuja. That's where I streaming live from. Yes, and my name is Wendy Ologe, and I'm the founder of the Intentional Parent Academy. So today, yes, today, what we are talking about is why must you become an emotionally intelligent parent? That's what we're talking about today. Why must you become an emotionally intelligent parent, okay? And why is it even needed in the first place? I'm going to be sharing a few things with you on this topic. Why must you manage your emotions to parent better? Okay, you know the drill. If you hear something that is very catchy for you, put in the fire emojis. We love the fire emojis. If you don't have it, find it. All right, we trade on the fire emojis. All right, then make sure that you are tagging a family member, sharing the link with them, or even a friend, because I have seen testimonials of people come up here just to say, do you know what? Just because someone invited me to TIP, I have done this. My life is this. My life is that. My parenting journey has changed. So that one person you are inviting might be the one person that will change everything, all right? So please invite someone, tag them to this conversation. As hot as ever, we're bringing it hot to you. Managing your emotions is a bedrock to parenting better. And somebody should also help us spoon the quotes as well. As you hear the quotes, put them in the comment section as well. Thank you so much. And I want to say thank you for 2021. It was such an awesome time running through over 50 programs, 50 weeks through the year, every week being on the program. It's exciting to be here on the first time. This is our first Tuesday of the year, and we're here live with you. Thank you so much for joining us every Tuesday. I know some people who joined us every Tuesday without fail, as in they are here every 2 p.m. And if they are not here, they are catching a replay. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's do this again in 2022. We're here already. So, hey, let's go. All right. So managing your emotions is the bedrock of parenting anyone better. That's something that you need to understand. When we started the academy program for the year, that's in December, one of the things that, you know, I told parents was, if you're going to do this better, then you want to work on your emotions. Because if you don't, then you're going to continue to struggle. So the things that we keep saying will come off to you as something that looks impossible because you can't handle the emotions that come with a lot of things. Parenting is a very emotional journey. Is it that you're excited that your child is doing something very extremely, you know, exciting and all of that? Or you are sad that your child is doing something that you do not want on all of that? So either way, there's a whole roller coaster of emotions that come with parenting. Okay. It's so to say, emotional intelligence is the ability to understand, to use, and to manage your emotions in positive ways. So even the emotions that we say that is negative in quote, they are actually emotions that can give you the way. We really don't categorize negative and positive. Every emotion is a data that will help you to know how to do things, you know, as you are going. All right. So it means being smarter with your feelings. It can help intentional parents to become more purposeful in their parenting. So the more you understand your emotions, the more you become more purposeful on your journey as a parent. I was saying this in the academy, and I said it took me years to be able to work on my emotions to parent better. Okay. So on my parenting journey, I've been able to come to a place where I can put my emotions in check even when things are going haywire. And that's one place you need to be if you're going to walk the intentional parenting journey. Very important. Okay. And one of the good things is that managing your emotions actually leads to better health. It leads to better and stronger relationships. And also, you know, puts you, there are lots and lots of disadvantages if you can manage your emotions better. Now, the question is, why must I manage my emotions to parent better? The reason for managing your emotions, you know, to parent better is not just about you, it's also about your child. Because if you manage your emotions better, it in turn helps your child, teach your child how to manage their emotions better. And it's been proven that children who are emotionally intelligent are easier to parent. The more emotionally intelligent your child is, the easier your parenting journey becomes. They have the ability to regulate their own emotional state. Children who are emotionally stable, they have the ability to regulate their own emotional state. They have the ability to better suit themselves when they're upset. They have the ability to better focus when it comes to attention. Part of the problem with many of the things that we have as regards attention in this time, it's also lack of emotional regulation. So we have quite a lot of that lack of emotional regulation somewhere. And, you know, the children are struggling. They're losing focus. They are, you know, throwing tantrum. They're everywhere. And you also will in turn continue to struggle. Children who are emotionally intelligent relate better. All right. Sorry, Facebook. I can see that. I can see that we had a bit of a network hitch. Children who are emotionally intelligent, actually, hi MB, hi Elojo, thank you so much for being here. Hi Obide, they're better focused, all right. Another point is that they relate better with people, even in tough situations. So children who are emotionally intelligent, even when they are upset, are able to relate better with people. So they have strong social connection, and it can build better relationships. Our theme for the Inner Circle program in January is social intelligence. So part of what we're teaching parents this month is how to, get their children to actually begin to build better social connections. Now, that would also be hinged on so many things like emotional intelligence. Emotional intelligence is key if you're going to build a better social connection. And also, it's also been proven that children who are more emotionally intelligent are more academically stable. They are more academically stable. They have more stability. They are able to, you know, do their exams better and all of that. I was sharing a conversation with a client some few days ago, and the children have been struggling academically. And when they were in primary school, I looked at their results. The results were, you know, what you call amazing, all right? What you call amazing. Uncle Ben, you're here. Good to see you here. What you call amazing, right? So And when the children started to go to secondary school, they started to struggle. And while I was having that conversation with her, I said to her, I said, your children are struggling because they lack the other skills that can support academic performance as they grow older. So you have a child who is struggling, who was doing so well primary school. In secondary school, the child begins to struggle. It's simple. It's not anything. It's not the child is playing too much. It is because the child did not build the skills that are required for them to actually be able to now, you know, manage the situation of things that come to them at that level and also be able to build that system, one of which is emotional stability. Because at that time, when they become teenagers, it's an emotional roller coaster. So a child who can't manage their emotions at the point where they now become teenagers and they are now suddenly, they are going to get distracted naturally because they can't manage what is happening to them. So they begin to struggle with whatever it is that they find. So at every point in time, your child doesn't even know what is wrong with them. They can't manage their emotions. In fact, I say to every parent that before your child gets to the point of puberty, make sure that you have actually helped your children understand emotional stability. So it is important that many of the things that your children go through when they become adolescents, actually as a result of lack of stability emotionally, because they can't handle what adolescents throw to them. Now, the stage of adolescence means that your child is between a bridge of being a child and a bridge of being an adult. And that's a lot for any child, all right? That's quite a lot for any child. And you must recognize that. It's a difficult place for any child to be in. So that already has its own way of destabilizing whatever it is, that is happening to the child at that time. So imagine that the child has better stability. Now that's where the children who perform better as they grow older are children who are now able to build the skills. Another skill is the study skill. Child who is able to actually lead them. So another skill is discipline. Unfortunately, we think in this part of the world that discipline is that you're screaming, you're beating your child. You know, when you ask a parent, how have you disciplined this child on this particular issue? The parent will say, I have been beating the child and nothing is changing. Because we misinterpret what discipline itself should be. Then when we get to that point, our children are not even disciplined enough to know what to do by time. So discipline is about the structures that the child creates. So if the child is not able to create those structures, the child will begin to struggle. School is opening. If the more disciplined your child is, the more emotionally stable your child is, the more they will perform better academically. Another pointer for academic performance is also responsibility. I know that quite a number of parents think that when their children have less responsibility, they would actually, be able to perform better. That's not true. Your children need a consummate, responsibility to their age to also be able to get to the point where they are responsible enough to take decisions. So you can see that academic performance really is not about what your child is reading or not reading. It's about the skills that you're building that is not just the reading. So yes, your child will be reading, but how about, the other things that you need to help your child stabilize? So when your child now gets to the point where there are a lot of distractions, will your child be able to stay focused? Will your child be able to look at the things that is happening around them and lead themselves? Will your child to be responsible enough to say, this is my life, I want to take responsibility? Would your child be stable enough emotionally to say, yes, I know that I feel this way, but I know that I need to do this? Now, these are the pointers that we need to create. Apart from the, you want to just let your children just, jump around, learn this, learn that, and all of that. These are actually the basics. Are you enjoying these conversations? If you are, please tag someone to this conversation. Share the link with them if you're watching on YouTube and tag someone to it. All right. Thank you so much, Uncle Ben. All right. Thank you. Yes. And it is very, very important. Another thing that also helps your children is that they are able to delay gratification. That's also one of the key parts of teaching emotional intelligence. Unfortunately, all of these things I'm saying is only feasible when you can teach it. Because you can't give what you do not have. It is what you have that you can give. I'm sure you must have heard me say this. You can't give what you don't have. It's a popular quote. We hear it every day. We see it everywhere. But when you think of it, when you actually sit back to have a think, a rethink of it, then you would begin to say to yourself, okay, this thing that I'm asking for my children, this thing that I'm putting together for my children to be able to, you know, do, what is it, you know, that I'm also able to teach? Have I been able to learn? Yes, Mary Beth, it's about your child staying focused amidst distractions. That's actually what makes the difference. And unfortunately for the children that we're raising today, the distractions are so much. So if you do not teach your children focus more than any other thing, every other thing that you're teaching will become null and void. So for me, focus is a big deal. Delayed gratification, it was still, you know, it's part of what your child is able to do. What does delayed gratification mean? It means being able to wait. Being able to gain something, you know, after a while. And it also means that you will be able to also teach this, show this. Are they able to delay gratification? How much gratification are children able to really delay? If your children are constantly, you say, oh, I put on the TV, I took the cable. It means that your children have a problem with delaying gratification. They can't do their chores before they watch a TV. There's a whole lot to it. And you need to now begin to teach. It's not by screaming or by jumping up and down or by hitting anybody. It doesn't get you the result, all right? So the result that you actually will give will be from the skills that you've been able to build, all right? Another thing is that they are able to motivate themselves. You don't want to be there, you know, where you're raising children and you tell yourself that you're going to be there all the time. That's not true. There are going to be times, several times, where you're not there and your children need to take decisions. Do they have emotional stability to be able to motivate themselves to the point where they can say, I want to. My children were in school, in secondary school for the first time, and it was almost an A slide, you know, result. It's not because they are extremely smarter than other people. No, it's because they understand, they have these skills, the basic skills that can help them to now be able to actually do the things that other children were not able to do. So while other children were crying, trying to manage their emotions, were just being irresponsible with their things, were always here and there, they were very focused because they understood to use those skills. So the time that they had. So it's not about being the smartest. It's actually about having those skills. So the little time that they had, because they had those skills, they were able to focus. And they were able to do so well because it wasn't difficult. They've already built the skills that help them get thrown anywhere, and they are able to think it through. All right. The next thing that you want to do is they have the ability to cope better. Children who are emotionally intelligent are more able to cope better. All right. A parent I had a session with 2 days ago, asked me, apart from your children going to boarding school to go and learn independent, what else do boarding school teach the children? I said, boarding school doesn't teach your children independence. And that's a mistake we've made over the years. A child who is not independent shouldn't even go to boarding school in the first place. All right? You shouldn't even go to boarding school in the first place. So that's by the way. And then, hey, because the conversation is not about boarding or day school, whichever one it is, the conversation is about the skills that you're building for your children to be able to cope wherever it is that they find themselves, all right? So the last one that I said is I talked about focus, all right? I talked about focus, the focus that you're able to build. Part of what we're doing, our team, like I said earlier, in the inner circle, is social intelligence. Part of what we're trying to do is to create more focus on the things that matter and take out the things that do not matter and begin to actually build systems that will help parents and their children to also be focusing. So we're going to be doing a lot on screen time. We're going to do a lot on too many other things, you know, and We're going to be sharing that just exclusive for the parents in the inner circle. Now, there are obstacles. You're going to hear some of these things. You're going to say, oh, my child has it. Oh, my child, they're, you know, I can do this. All right. And yes, but you need to also recognize that there are obstacles that parents face that make it difficult for them to provide sound parenting guidance to their children. There are three of them. I'm going to talk about two. The third one is a core of what we're doing this month in the inner circle. So time might not permit me to actually be able to do that. And we won't share our curriculum out here anyway. So number one is our cultural overemphasis on mental intelligence. It's an obstacle to providing sound parental guidance to our children. I'm going to tell you how. So while we focus on academics, we unconsciously begin to minimize emotional intelligence. We begin to minimize social intelligence. Now then, and studies have shown that only 20% of what makes your child successful is actually that IQ. So we have children, all right? We have children who are academically sound, but they can't thrive because they do not have all the other cues, the quotients that they need to thrive. And I dare to also add cultural intelligence, social intelligence, spiritual intelligence, as well as emotional intelligence. So your children will need to be able to, and it's accounted. Studies show that this accounts for 80% of their success rate. 80%. So when I was going through quite a number of interviews of who you would call the impact makers of the world in the recent times. That's part of the things I have done, started doing, all right, in the past few weeks. And when we listen to many of these impact makers, I was able to pick out three common attributes that these impact makers were able to actually put together to become who they have become today. Number one is integrity. Number two is discipline. Number three is social skills. I'm going to, share a bit about this. And these whole qualities are all related together in one. They all have the ability to tap into and regulate in their inner lives. That's what these three attributes have in common. All right, let me say that again. Integrity, discipline, good social skills. And I say that all of them are correlated. And they all have the ability to tap into and regulate their inner lives. So that's why they are all interrelated. For instance, integrity is rooted in moral framework on how, to be honest and how to treat others right with respect. That's what integrity is rooted on. You can see the interrelatedness of these three things. Number two is discipline. It involves delayed gratification. Now, being able to put forth determined effort to accomplish your goals. It involves delayed gratification. And being able to put forth a determined effort to accomplish your goals. Now, can you see what discipline itself is about? So discipline is not about forcing your child to do something. Discipline is about getting your child to the point where they have learned delayed gratification and they are able to put forth a determined effort. A determined effort to accomplish your goals. Discipline. There's a limit to what anybody can achieve without discipline. You will limit yourself without discipline. I'm talking about discipline, the real sense of it. And I was listening to the kids and my children, and they were telling us about, a few students, about two, three of them, who were in exam halls, kind of writing exams. And when they just got tired and they didn't know what it was that they were going to write, they just slept off, this kind just went their way. All right. So the effort to accomplish your goals. Until you understand and define discipline appropriately, then it becomes a struggle because your child will not be able to lead themselves to achieve and accomplish whatever goal, including you, because discipline also cuts across. Then the third one, social skills. Social skills are the ability to make and maintain relationships built on trust and respect. In the inner circle, like part of what we are going to our webinar topic is creating a social roadmap for your Gen Z. One of the reasons why we took to teach that is because we have realized that social connectivity is something that has been thrown into the bush as we speak. Children wake up in the morning, they're on holiday, they are playing game from morning to night, or they're watching TV. There's something wrong with that. And it's something that we need to begin to undo. And part of what it is that we're doing today is, remember what I said about the three things that have made the millionaires of the times till today is integrity, discipline, and good social skills. Some of them do not even have a degree. Some of them do not have, that's one of my findings. Don't get me wrong. I am for education, whatever degrees that you want to pack. I have so many of them as well. It's fine. But it's just 20% of your success rate. The other 80%, what happens to it? So if you just have just that, you're limiting yourself. That's what I'm trying to say. You're limiting yourself to the things that you are supposed to be doing. Okay? So that's it. All right. So social skills. How do you teach social skills? What do you need to do? How do you need to begin to create all of that and all of that and all of that? Well, that's another kettle of fish, right? But it needs to start from you. You, the parent, will need to understand exactly social skills. What exactly do I need to do for my child? You know, and how do I need to teach my child to begin to relate? When we were growing up, creating a social roadmap for us was not a big deal. We could stay on the field and we learned so much. I tell someone that many of us learned so much on the playground. Our children can't learn them anymore because those environments are no longer there. So if you're not intentional enough, you're going to just raise children who will have the 20% and we end up not being able to thrive. Very important. Who's enjoying this session? Are you taking screenshots? Did you share to your stories so that you can invite people before we go on to the last segment of this conversation? Who is enjoying this session? If you are, let me see your comment in the comment section and let me see you say that you have invited someone. Have you invited someone to join you here? The whole essence of intentional parenting, of doing this publicly, is also to get more and more people to begin to look at intentional parenting as something that they want to try. All right. Intentional parenting is actually very, it gives you peace. That's the word. It gives you peace. And if you are able to buy that peace, you can buy it. All right. You can buy it at every point in time. You can buy it. So you enjoy, enjoy it and, you know, invite people, send them the link, let them come and, you know, learn a lot and put all of this, you know, together. Okay. So I stopped at where I said that one common three things that I noticed about the millionaires of the world, and the impact makers, I like to call them the impact makers. One of the things that I'm able to, you know, put one of the things that I'm able to put together is when I listen, I'm able to put something that will help every single, you know, to help me to actually, you know, relate. And I said that the three things are integrity, discipline, and social skills. These are the three things that every someone, all right, should learn to actually be able to succeed. Yes, just share the link, Taiwo Akinwade. Share the link with your friends and your family, and they will be here. The second thing that actually it's a big problem. The second thing that is a big problem that can limit our parenting is we often are not connected to our own emotions. There's a lot of disconnect. We're not connected. We are running, but we're running without a message. I like the way that Coach Ibuka for the boys says it. We're running without a message. We're everywhere, okay? We're everywhere running. There's so much chaos. There's so much happening at the same time. And yet, when there's really, we can't connect. It's because of, you know, the environment we find ourselves. We're not connected. One of the reasons why we're not connected is perpetual busyness. When there's really, we can't connect. Sorry about that. Yes. Okay, so we have what we call the perpetual busyness. You are constantly busy. Everything, once they just tell you anything, just say, I'm just busy, I'm busy, I'm busy. Perpetual busyness. Your timing is so clogged with a lot of things. You are constantly busy. There's no time. You do not have time to reflect. You do not have time to think. You do not have time to say, to stop and look at how it is that, you know, what you're doing per time. One of the things that I tell the parents in the academy is that this academy makes you think. You become a thinker and not just somebody who is just, you know, going about just doing whatever it is that everybody is doing. You begin to think. You begin to think. And that's very important, you know, to us. Well, you begin to think about the things that you're doing. You're not just, you know, doing them because, you know, people are just saying it and all of that. You are thinking. You're constantly, you know, thinking. That perpetual busyness is a problem. You need to cut yourself off from all of those. You are everywhere. You are, I know some people, they are in like 10 WhatsApp groups, 20. Some are on 50 WhatsApp groups. Yeah, you're constantly busy. You're chatting. You spend 20 hours in a day trying to press the phone. Perpetual business. Then you are running. Some of us are also now running our business, always on the run. All right? You are perpetually busy. Part of the affirmations that the parents in the inner circle took when they came in is that I have time to parent my child, because that's one of the things I don't even want to hear. So you come in and you say, oh, I don't have time to parent my children. I do not have time to sit. Are you kidding? You must have time. You can't be on this perpetual busyness and just run your life. You won't be able to connect to who you are. Number two is focusing on tasks. You're constantly, let me just do it. You're constantly focusing on the future without living in the present. A lot of us don't live in the present. We're so worried about the future. You're so, you know, we're constantly, oh, this one, that one. You're constantly, you know, worried, you know, about the future. Now, don't get me wrong. I did not say don't plan. I am saying try to also look at where the present is taking you to as well. So some of us live either in the past, in the future. Some of us live in that. I've seen a lot of parents that live in the past. And I've seen so many that live in the future. What if my child does not, you're constantly not savoring the moment. You're not creating the connections that are needed. Earlier today, I shared something. And I said, that, you know, if you do not connect with your child today, you will not be able to connect with your teenagers tomorrow. So if your toddler is not able to connect with you, you're constantly busy, you're going on tasks, let me do. Hey, when they grow, the children will grow and they will not know you. Many of us are raising children we know nothing about. Many of us are raising children who know nothing about us. And it's a big deal. It should worry you. So because we have used that, you know, we're constantly on the run, we're so focused on the task that we forget to live. That's one of the things that I keep telling the parents in the academy, you need to connect first. If you're not connecting, you can't parent. My book, Connect to Correct, all right? My book, Connect to, that's what I'm even wearing. Oh, what again? So my book, Connect to Correct. Connect to Correct is the book we're reviewing in level one in the inner circle currently. And one of the things that I say is that you cannot correct someone you don't understand who they are. So connection parenting is your anchor. If you're not connecting, you're going to struggle with your teenagers. So when people tell me things like, oh, they are teenagers, that's why you can't connect with them. No, that's not true. It's because the times that you were supposed to connect with them, your children are changing daily and you didn't recognize it. You were waiting for them to grow. Meanwhile, change is so noiseless that you don't see it. Your children are growing every minute, every second. So sometimes we share some things, you say, I will do it later. My children are not old enough for me to do this. Or you say, all these things, so don't worry, I'll join the academy later. Next year, when my children are 10, or maybe when they are 11, the children are growing every day. So as the children are growing, something is changing on a daily basis. By the time you now begin, because change is so noiseless, you don't even understand that you have lost connection. So your children are wondering, who are you? They don't know you. You don't know them. You're a stranger. Many of us are parenting as strangers in our home. You're just a figure, an authority figure, someone who is just there hovering about, you're just there. Nothing else is happening. But, you know, you think your children know you. That sometimes, you know, some people come and see me, they say, I'm really connected with my children. We really spend time. When I do 1, 2, 3 bar research and all of that, you find out that the children are not even connected in any way. They are lost. You are lost. You don't know who you are parenting. I had a session with a parent 2 days ago, and I had sat with her team. And her team told me some things about herself. And I asked this parent, what do you know about your daughter? She said, I know that she does this. I know that she likes this. Everything she said was null and void. It was a lie. She didn't know. I listened to her with so much pity. That's the word. Because her teenager was someone else. And she was saying her teenager was someone else. So she doesn't even know who she's parenting. So how on earth do you begin to parent who you don't know? You can only parent who you know. You can only parent who you know, who you understand, who you are connected with. That's what parenting is about. And that's why you need to understand that this emotional disconnect is a big deal. And because we have all of these things in the space, we can't connect to ourselves. And the moment you can't connect to yourselves, you cannot be able to relate. I was on the phone with a parent today, and in a while I was talking, there was just a lot of, you know, noise. She doesn't know, coach, I want to. And I said to her, you are not emotionally connected to yourself. It struck her. And she said, really? Because she was just moving. It's not the same thing. Moving and being connected to yourself, they're not the same thing. All right? And another point is, there's a lack of modeling. You are, because you're not emotionally connected to yourself, that's part of it. You do something else, you expect your children to do something else. We're constantly contradicting our parenting journey, constantly. And the children are constantly looking at you and wondering, what is this one talking about? So you cannot parent someone, you know, you do. You can only parent the child you know and connect with. So that lack of modeling is a big deal. So I see a lot of parents, you just say, hey, they are children, they should know now. What are you doing? And I say often that we hold our children to the standards that we ourselves are not even able, you know, are not even able to hold those standards to ourselves. It's a big deal. It's a problem. So if you're going to do this, then you need to actually model. Another problem is that emotion is not considered as a parenting tool. That's why we're not connecting to our emotions. Many of the times you see parents, you talk about, when you enter the academy, I tell you that the first thing you need to do is to work on your emotions. I've said it over and again to the parents in the inner circle. And you know, anytime I say it, some parents are feeling, these emotions now. Oh, that's the bedrock of parenting. And because if you do not see emotion as a parenting tool, then you can't parent effectively. Because emotion is one of the biggest parenting tools ever. And if you're able to get that, you know, foundation right, then you are going to be on your way to the promised land. All right. Then the last one is that there is an unresolved emotional issues from how you were raised. That's another thing that makes us to disconnect. You have there's a lot of unresolved emotional issues. There are a lot of things that you're battling with from the past. And then you bring it into your parenting journey and you cannot connect with yourself. So provided you have unresolved issues in the past, there's a course that we do, Parenting Hearts, Healing from Parenting Hearts. Many of the times when I say this thing, I know where I have coached parents for years, thousands of them, to understand that these issues are universal. And I'm talking about cut across. In the inner circle, currently, we have Americans in there. So I'm talking about cut across every tribe. Unresolved emotional issues from the past can actually bridge you from being able to connect with who you are and who you have become. Now, the question is, how do I even begin to do all of this? You must become emotionally intelligent. You must become emotionally intelligent. If you're not emotionally intelligent, forget it. This whole conversation is not for you. If you're not ready to work on your emotions, forget it. If you're here, you're listening, and you're saying, all these things, I beg, all these, let me just do it my way. You're going to continue it, and it's going to be generational, which is one of the problems that I even have with the parenting system. It's become generational. We are beginning to do the things that our parents did. You can't help it, because parenting characteristics are reflective. They will reflect. So you're making a mess of generations to come. So you can make a decision today. I want to break whatever it is. So the things that we call generational curses are actually unresolved parenting issues. Many of them. Many of them. All right? So how do you become emotionally intelligent? You want to be able to. How do you know? You must be able to make sense of your own emotions, be able to express that emotions in a way that helps you to meaningfully connect with the next person and with your child. So if you're still in this place, you say, that's how I am. I explode when I'm angry. You have a problem. You have a problem. You don't need to. You don't need to. So you can't continue to say, that's how I am. That's how I am means that you just want to continue, you know, the trail and all of that. There's always something to work on as an individual as you are going. You can't parent anybody effectively without becoming emotionally intelligent. Number two, you must be able to accurately read the emotional cues that you have and that of your child, and you begin to validate what those cues are, which is why many of the times, every year, we start off the year with the emotional, becoming the emotionally intelligent parent. And that course usually is one of our, I think it's only twice in a quarter, in a year, that it comes up. And currently, we might not even be able to run it more than once because our calendar is full for the year. I'm looking at the calendar, it's only once it appears. If it happens to come up again, then that's it, it comes up again. But for now, we are sure of this one quarter. All right, I'm going to take your questions, but before I take your questions, I want to also announce to you that we have opened slots for you to be able to register for Becoming the Emotionally Intelligent Parent course. That course is a course in the academy. Please note, the Inner Circle program is a program in the academy like this, you know, course. So for people who are asking me, I can see some personal chats talking about the Inner Circle. You can only now book a slot for 2023. The Inner Circle in 2022 is done. We've gone 1 month over. If you come in, you would actually be confused. So book a slot already. We have about how many slots booked? 10 or so. And we have a few slots we're opening up for next year, because already we have over 1,000 parents in the Inner Circle program. So you can book a slot for 2023. It's a good time to book a slot. Okay? It's a good time for you to book a slot. So book a slot now. All right, for 2023, so that we will not tell you that you can't enter the academy in 2023. We start 1st of December every year. We already started the Inner Circle program the 1st of December last year. So we're already over 1 month gone. If you want to make the best of it, you start, you know, at the beginning. While you're at it, while you're waiting to join the academy in 2020, you can do the courses, you know, that we are flagging off in the academy, like this one. It's also going to help you get the books, read them. Who are currently reading Connect to Correct. You can join us and read on your own. It's just that you will not have me to directly explain it to you, all right? That's the advantage that the parents in the Inner Circle have. Now, part of what the Emotionally Intelligent Parent course is, it's a course, you know, so it's starting off on the, I'm trying to look at my team to give me the date. All right, I'm waiting for you guys to type the date here. Starting off, I think that should be second week in February. Registration already opens from today. The course fee for that course is 20,500 naira. Early bird fee currently between now and the 18th is 15,500 naira. And for the parents in the inner circle, you have a 50% discount all the time for all the academic courses. So you have a 10,000 naira payment if you are going for the course. You will get all the information in the Telegram channel for the parents in the inner circle. So if you have a question, you can ask me. If you want to be part of the course, just put course in the comment section and you will be reached for the details. If you are on YouTube, all you need to do is to send us a chat. All you need to do is to send us a chat, okay? Send us a chat, or you will look at the description of the video when we are done. Or you look at the description of the video when we are done, and then you can go ahead, or you will get the information on our Telegram community, because I know that is where it is. If you are in the inner circle, please reach out to the admin and sort yourself out with your registration. Okay, so if you want to be part of it, just put course in the comment section. If you're watching me on Facebook, put course in the comment section. I'll reach out to you with the details. You will see it's a self-paced course and also some live sessions, webinars that will come with it that we're going to have together. It's a 10-week program, 10th of February. Thank you. It's a 10-week program, a 10-week full program that you can do at your pace. It's actually online, so you can take it from anywhere you are. It's online on our website. So you can, anywhere you are in the world, anywhere at all, you can actually be part of that course, okay? And then you can also take it at your pace. What it means is that on the 10th of February, we're going to walk you through how you can do the course, and you have a whole 10 weeks to be able to go through the course and then have a result from it. We would also be there to lead you, to help you go through all of that. And I said that if you're watching on YouTube, please send a chat. All right, send a chat. You can send a chat to the team if you are parents in the inner circle, so that your discount can be applied to you. All right. You can always catch replay. Someone said I missed this. You can always catch replay of this session. All right. You said something about validation of emotion. Yes, when we talk about validating emotions, what we mean is that when you're validating an emotion, right? Precious, somebody needs to be on the Facebook community to actually attend to the parents who want to be part of that course. Does the course include a parenting plan? No, the course does not include a parenting plan, Ma. If you want to get a parenting plan, that's a different kettle of fish, okay? And when a child does something, if you recognize, for instance, a child comes to say, your child is crying. It is your duty, okay? It's your duty for you to recognize that that's an emotion that the child is sad, okay? An emotion that the child is sad, and then you cannot validate that emotion. I know that you feel this way, and I am here to help you. So that validating that emotion is even valid in the first place. Many of the times what we do is that a child is crying, you shut the child up. You tell the child, why are you crying? Why are you getting angry? We even tell children things like, why are you getting angry? Why do you want to get angry? Yes, the child is valid. Anger is a valid emotion. Crying, getting overwhelmed is a valid emotion. So instead of saying, why are you crying? You can validate why, what is the reason behind that cry? All right, these are part of the things that we are also, these are part of the things that we're also going to be teaching in Becoming the Emotionally Intelligent Parent, where you will be able to, you know, get in tune with your emotions and be able to validate them, be able to put all of them all together and then work with it. I don't think that I can see any more questions. It is 10 minutes to go. If you're able to connect with your child today, if you want to be able to connect with your teenagers tomorrow, yes. So you can send to me. If you do not have questions, share with me, what is your biggest takeaway, your biggest quote in today's conversation? Somebody is actually asking a question. What is what is parents have, what if parents have different opinions? Like a child is beaten and you say you shouldn't cry. How do you handle this? A child is beaten. I don't understand this, please. You are telling a child not to cry. The question is, why are you telling a child not to cry? If a child is crying, why are you telling the child, why are you crying? The child, if something makes you want to cry, then a child should cry. So or you say things like, stop crying. You need to first of all validate. Why won't a child cry? A child needs to cry now. Everybody cries, you know. So it's actually making me laugh that we're asking that question, why a child should cry. A child should cry. So it's okay for you. My point is that it's a valid emotion, okay? It's a valid emotion for a child to cry. It's not abnormal. And don't, a child you beat, you're saying you shouldn't cry. My dad does that a lot. Oh, you're saying, what if your spouse have a different opinion? Oh, well, you need to continue to encourage your spouse and you guys continue to have conversations to have the same opinion when it comes to parenting, because that's the only way really to actually get it right. All right. I'm also in the inner circle. If you're in the inner circle, please reach out to Augustine. That's the TIP team link so that you'll be able to get all the details that you need. Yes. If you're not connecting, you will struggle. Yes, that's the word. You will struggle. How do I help my son? He's 5 years. He cries over everything. He lacks emotional stability, man. Okay, Tochukwu, what you need to do is to help your child build emotional stability. All right? Build emotional stability. If you do that, your child will be able to manage their emotions better. That's what I shared earlier. So, you know, then you must tell him something for everything before he keeps quiet. No, you don't need to tell him sorry for anything. You need to teach him how to handle his emotions when they come. Very important. All right. Someone says, what is this course different from managing emotion we have last year? Oh, you had a challenge. This course is a full-blown course. It's a 10-week course. All right. Takes you 10 weeks. Can do it in 1 week if you're fast, but 10 weeks take one module, this thing of the weeks and all of that, and then you do the reviews and all of that. So this is a lot more different. That's like an abridged version of what you had. If you're able to connect with your child today, yes, people are sharing their biggest quote, change is noiseless. Yes, I'm interested in the courses, I'm also in the next level. Yes, my biggest quote, I cannot parent a child I have not connected with. I have to be emotionally intelligent to properly parent. Yes, please, can I encourage my child to explain herself whenever she does something that I looked at as it is wrong? Yeah, encourage your child. You can encourage your child. You can always encourage your child to say what they feel. Yeah. At the same time, it all also depends on what it is, the circumstances and the conditions that have that in place. Okay. So that's also one of the things that I consider when it comes to discipline. Sometimes when we're talking about verbal correction, we say that when you give the child this thing, or when you're correcting and you say, oh, so why did you do this? When you ask the whys, you will find out that the child will always have an excuse. So you're teaching your child that for every wrong thing I do, I must have an excuse for it. Now, instead of excuse, why not teach them to take responsibility? All right. So that's a different conversation altogether. When we're if you're in the inner circle, when we're reading The Discipline That Works next month, I'm going to break it down in pieces for you a lot. And you're also going to have access to a particular course. If you're in the inner circle, you're going to have access to a course free called The Discipline That Works. And then you'll be able to take it at your pace as well. How do I build or teach this emotional intelligence? You need to build it first before you can teach it. So if you do not build it yourself, teaching it becomes difficult. The question should be, how do I build it first? How can you build it first? Start by learning. Start by taking courses, start by reading, so you can build on it. So as we're going, part of the first work on emotional intelligence for us in the academy is Connect to Core. The next work is for us to build on it and read other books on connecting to your girl child, connecting to your boy child. And then the next work is for us to do social intelligence and Daniel Coleman. So we climb on it. So it doesn't stop. I'm still learning on how to build my emotions as we're going. So it doesn't stop. You're going to continue to do that, all right? If you're a parent in the inner circle, you're reading Connect Correct, you already understand a lot of the things that I've shared here, and you can raise, you can feel it, you can think it, you know, as we're going. So thank you, everybody. I don't think that I have any questions. So if you want to be part of the course, all you need to do is to just put course in the comment section. And if you're watching me on YouTube, you'll see the details on the description so that you'll be able to reach out and register for the course. All right. So one step at a time. All right. Thank you so much for joining me for the first Tuesday Live in 2022. I feel excited. I feel like, you know, back to work. I wasn't going to come here. And then my team just insisted, coach, you need to be here. All right. So, but I'm glad that I did this. I enjoyed it thoroughly myself. I am so glad. Anytime when I share, you know, knowledge, I am so glad, so glad that there are people who are here constantly listen. All right. So by this time next year, some of our teenagers will be going to higher institution. Will the inner circle still be necessary? The inner circle have parents of adults. Parents of adults, trust me. If I will have a parent who's, oh, we have grandparents for the record. We have grandparents, yeah. We have about 3 grandparents in the inner circle. We have a parent whose last child is 19. So the truth is, the earlier the better. But whatever it is that you find yourself, then start and you run. You run with it. Okay. So thank you so much, everybody, for being part of it. Thank you, everybody. Thanks you making more effort to connect more and more. Yes, Mama Purity, I see you, Vitima Ume. Thank you so much. You did not answer my question. Who is this? Please, can you copy? Hey, sis, I see my sister is here. Interestingly, my mom is not here today, and I'm sure my sister is watching, and my mom is watching from here. Olori, I didn't see your question. I'm trying to scroll back to see if I can see it, but I cannot see it. And the person who was telling me about the children going to school next year, get your children to also enroll to the, I think Etima has one back to school for going to university, a transition to campus kind of thing. All right, I just look out for it, because we're going to talk about it when that time also comes. But you need to just start now, start today, okay? Thank you, sis. I see you. There's a question you didn't respond to. I'm trying to find it. I didn't say it. I'm trying to find it. If you can, how long do I have access to the course? 10 weeks. After 10 weeks, you have another 10 weeks. So that's, we give you opportunity to have 10 weeks and 10 weeks back to back to it, to have access to that course so that you'll be able to take it. How do I control a 4-year-old girl who asks you to beat her to stop crying? There's a problem with that. You need to actually seek help. I might not be able to say some of the things that I would need to say here. So please reach out. And if you need to book a session with us, please do that and then deal with it. But a girl, controlling, asking her to beat that, so it means that there's a lot that happened underneath and needs to be dealt with. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you, thank you. And thank you for all your congratulatory messages. I got it. All right. Yes, yes, yes. At the end of 2021, I was named one of the best 20 Christian coaches in the world. Something that I am grateful for, because you are there. Thank you so, so much. All right. Susan Taribi says, inner circle is compulsory. It's compulsory for every human being. That's a good one. Thank you so much, Susan, for that vote of confidence. All right, your partner shouting at your kids in front of your kids. I already said that to you, that you need to work it out with your partner. I might not be able to, you know, tell you here now, like magic, what it is that you need to do. It's a process you need to walk it through, all right, as you are going. Thank you so much for joining me again. And thank you for all your goodwill messages. I saw it. I see it. So, hey, if you're working with me now, you're working with one of the best coaches in the world. Yes, 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 yes. You can say that, and I'll be glad to answer. All right. Thank you so much, and have an amazing, amazing Tuesday.